Ladies and gentlemen, you are hearing, we're not live yet. Well, if you're watching this video, we're live enough for you. We're not really live, but we're live enough for you. But if you're waiting for us to be on the Facebooks, you're live streaming on Facebook, right?
I'm live streaming on Facebook now, actually.
Now
we are
now,
live.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are live.
On Napod TV.
Lozilla, breaking news. Breaking news. This Justin, Lozilla the Lizard, has been found alive and well, and Lozilla is ready for the lulz. Details coming up, not in the show. It's coming up though. No, there are details. There will be details. Let's just say that it involves Hanna-Barbera, and it involves the South Pole. We're not gonna say anything more than that. You know what I'm saying?
I see how it is.
What? You know what's going on. You and I have been digging into the research, and we missed the Lozard. We did
miss the Lozard, but we have an idea of his location.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's alive and well. We know that.
There is some concern for a while.
Oh, yeah. But, I mean, we have been looking and working far and wide, trying to figure out what the heck happened, what went wrong, how did he just fall off the face of the planet. I don't think he's ready to come back and do
not
things
full
right.
Force.
No, not full force. This is just like a hello, letting everybody know that the Lozilla the Lizard is still alive. He's well, I guess, relatively speaking, really. I mean, I say well as in... He's not missing any appendages. If he was, he grew them back. Ask me how I know. I'm not going to go into that.
So that's not an appendage, Paul.
Dude, that was... Actually, it is an appendage. See, that's the thing.
Well, I guess, do you know why T-Rex was... dinosaurs in general were so unhappy?
I do not. Is this going to be like a corny joke? Am I going to hate you for this?
Well, yeah, they can't reach.
All dinosaurs can't reach?
Most of them.
Most of them?
They don't have long arms.
Most of them? They can't reach? You know, the dog is the superior species.
Yes.
Dog. More superior than the human. I'll let you figure out why. So what I'm going to do is...
Ask me how I know.
Yeah. Ask me how... Go ahead. Ask me how I know. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Hey, banana. Oh, no. He's not spayed. He's not neutered. Ask me how I know. Go ahead. Ask me how I know. You got the reference, right?
You're Carl. I get it.
Are you making fun of my Carl? Because my Carl will kick your Carl's proverbial. You know, I'll come over there right now with the New York Giants, and I will kick you a Florida! Florida!
I like the New York Post, actually.
I said the New York Giants, dude, because that's
I thought you said the New York Times.
No, Carl's favorite team is the New York Giants, and he likes Foreigner. Hot-blooded!
I'm not familiar
Remember
with
the
pop
Foreigner?
Culture.
Oh, my gosh. You're not down with Aqua Teen Hunger Force? What the?
Not that well, man. I told you. I haven't had a TV since I was, like, 16.
You're not familiar with pop culture.
No.
Why the heck? Why are you on this show? Because this show is about pop culture.
I'm just here to criticize you for your abject failure of communicating thoughts clearly.
I am an abject failure as a human being, absolutely. So I'm not able to share with anybody right now. So, Bodhi, you're going to have to share.
I just shared it to my page.
That's all you did? And we're on Napaw TV. So
make sure you like the page.
Well, you're not. Oh, yeah, we are liking now. In the beginning, we were not liking, but now.
Yeah, I had plenty of public service. The Void had plenty of public service announcements to not like the page. It was
part of
an experiment.
Yeah, I'm wondering what people think of when they see the Void actually podcasting. Because right now, the Void is actually podcasting right now. But what's interesting is this, that we are. While we're podcasting here, I'm recording a different version of what you guys see, which looks...
Yeah.
Well, it's different, so it looks...
It's completely different.
it looks completely different because it's a different version. So, on this show, I'm just going to go to a headline. You know, hold on. I got it. This is a teaching
break it
hospital.
Down. Break
so,
it down.
So I'm actually, I need to share this.
Break it down.
I just want to share this and make sure that my buddy Larry sees this. Because Larry's feelings were hurt. Yesterday, I did not share and let Larry know that we were live. And Larry missed it live.
Oh, he was upset. It to Larry's wall.
I just shared it with Larry. I just tagged Larry.
I'm going to share it right to his wall.
Larry is my resident State of On State based friend. I'm sure
Did he unfriend me?
No way. No way Larry unfriended you. Larry! 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 Hold on. I'm going to message him right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this is important.
What the hell?
Larry! 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 Did you unfriend Bodie? Are you kidding me? You did not do that.
Son of a bitch.
Wait, no, it didn't record. Larry, did you unfriend Bodie? You let me know.
What kind of an asshole?
I can't believe that Larry would. Larry's commenting on the video, so let's see if Larry is. Because we're actually in the future, so he's going to be responding to the past. He says, I'm here. Larry is here already.
Did you unfriend me, Larry?
Larry, did you unfriend? Did you unfriend the Boadster? No, I like Andrew. He did not unfriend you, so I wouldn't think he would do that. That'd be weird. I'm going to jump into the first headline and see what you think of it. Ready?
Lay it on.
And what we're doing it now, by the way, we ain't playing crap. We're just doing it.
This is real life.
This is real life.
We're actually just floating embodiments of voices.
So, the first thing I'm clicking on, fisherman Leonard Vanderpool, catfish falls from sky, lands in family pool.
The dream come true.
Yeah. So, I'm listening to this. Oh, it's a video. It's not an article, so I can't read it. But apparently, this whopper of a tale is about catfish falls from sky, lands in family pool,
that just came plummeting down,
and crashed through his pool cage,
then plopped into the
pool. Crazy. But it's a video. I can't. It's no audio. I mean, there's no article for me to read. So this is, folks, what happens when you just do it live. We're gonna just have to find another article. But hey. Yeah. What about that though? Catfish
falls from the sky. Is that where there were storms and tornadoes?
You know what I think it is? I think it's
that's where it's raining cats and dogs, or it's like raining frogs. That's where it came from.
I think it's
tornado culture.
I actually think it's the hand of cod. That's
the hand of cod.
The hand of cod is at work. All hail cod.
The invisible cod in the sky.
All hail cod, dropping catfish on me, man. So yeah, you're telling the studio audience about the catfish, raining cats and dogs and frogs, and I've never heard anybody say it's raining frogs though. So.
Oh really? Well, it depends what subculture of Kansas you're part of.
I'm not part of any Kansas culture.
Me neither.
Otherwise.
I read it on Reddit once.
I'm not allowed to be after the Dorothy incident, and I don't want to talk about the Dorothy incident.
And you were there.
A man put something weird on his pizza, and people can't decide whether it's a good idea. What do you think? Do we click on it and go on to the next one? Come on.
Let's see what he put on. What did he put on the
all
pizza?
Right. I don't know. I'm clicking on it right now to find out.
The only thing you shouldn't put on pizza is pineapple.
Ah! No way. Oh,
it's not good.
Oh, no. A man has put tinned spaghetti on his pizza. However, pineapple also played a role. I am very triggered.
I'm done with this article.
No, I'm too. We're passing on this, folks. I'm sorry. This is disgusting. I don't even know. Actually, you know, I'm not for laws in general, but I am now for laws if we can prevent stuff like this from showing up on our news feeds.
Why do people need to know about pineapple?
Nobody needs to know. Other than pineapples, like by themselves in a healthy breakfast drink. That's
Do you know what pineapple's sole purpose is to humanity?
It's to kill us from the inside out.
No, it actually changes the flavor of a certain bodily fluid of males.
I'm assuming you mean their tears.
Tears.
I'm assuming you mean their. Yeah. I'm assuming you. Okay, we're gonna move on to terrified.
Tears from the appendage.
we're talking about appendages again. Terrified. Yeah. If we talk about appendages four times in the show, Bodhi is going to give away to a random studio appendage audience member display. the mixer that he just got from his brother. No. So that's decent of you. But only if we mention it four times.
Look at my appendage.
You've said it four times now. So
it's invisible.
We're gonna have to pick one of our two listeners to receive, or viewers, whichever the case might be. How about terrified TV crew discovers huge crocodile in floodwaters, but find it's not all that it seems? We're clicking on it.
What else could it be? What else
we're diving in, folks. We are diving into this story.
It better this be a is, dinosaur.
By the way, I'm at mirror.uk.com. I'm in their weird news section. So wow. I
remember to go to Japan after this, because there'll be some weird stuff
Japan.
There.
I don't know. Oh no! It wants me to ask a survey. I answer a survey to see the article, but I don't want to. I'm violating your nap and avoiding the survey altogether.
All right, next article.
A TV crew were on alert when they spotted what appeared to be a huge crocodile in floodwaters. Australia.
How big was it?
How big was it? All right, you crazy kids. Boy, if this was the Gong Show, we would have been gone by
what?
Now.
I thought that was Match Game.
No, you're right, but I was mixing and, it was like 70s, whatever.
I love Match Game.
And, Chuck Willery died recently. Oh. Right after Chuck Barrelly died. It was Chuck Barrelly and then Chuck Willery. Whoa.
What, not That's, to name your kids?
I think Chuck Schumery. I think Chuck Schumery may die next. You know. So they found this huge crocodile. Australia's 7 News Sunrise Show has reported on the recent devastating floods. Blah it's blah Australia. Blah. Who cares? Come on. We have just seen what we thought was a crocodile. A crocodile, reporter Bianca Stone said, pointing to a head peering above the surface of the water. It's a crocodile! It's a crocodile! It's a crocodile! Okay, come on, give me the. And then, fortunately for the terrified crew, had taken the roads, to the flood roads by boat. The mammoth reptile was just
an alligator,
a garden ornament. Oh man, that was kind of weak. That story I was expecting something. I mean, this is weird news, folks. That is lame. That is.
What is wrong with the planet?
I know. If you can't have a weird news section of your site that actually
that is
sloppy
weird journalism.
News, that's absolutely sloppy journalism. I do not approve of any of it. Absolutely Real life. Ridiculous. I don't know what's a Mowgli girl. Mowgli? Is that the Jungle Book thing?
I thought that just meant malnourished.
No. You just
too soon.
Yeah, too soon. So I'm not even going to click on it. It just says, real life Mowgli girl found living with monkeys and walking on all fours in remote nature reserve. Dude, you know,
I'd
just
tap it.
If you want to.
I'd hit it.
Okay, I just want to say.
I'd hit it with a club and take it to my cave.
She's 9 years old.
Oh.
Oh. Awkward. By the way, if you want to see a real life girl.
They're gonna have to call me Jared now.
Found living with monkeys and walking. Oh, nobody's gonna get that.
Nobody
outside a small circle will get that.
It's there for me.
And we're not explaining it to the larger circle, assuming we have a larger circle. Never mind. I don't want to talk too much about circles because I know it's gonna get back to appendages somehow. So
circles, drawing circles.
Right. Man. So if you want to see a girl walking with monkeys on all fours, just come to my house. They're here. It's not. There's nothing special or unusual about that. You know what? I'm done with this. I am done with the Mirror UK's lame excuse for weird news. What do you say we check out celebrities?
Yeah, let's go to the celebrities.
Let's go see.
I heard there's some things with Donald Trump. He's quite the celebrity.
We're not gonna. No. This is a no DT zone. I'm gonna just make that rule. This is a no D zone. All that right. doesn't sound right. Then we get back to appendages again, and I don't want to get back to appendages.
You keep bringing it up. It's on your mind.
I'm bringing it up. Okay.
It's on your mind. My microphone, actually.
Really? You should be careful with your wording there. Donald Trump Oh, my gosh. Are you kidding me?
What?
The first headline in the celebrity thing is about Mr. Junior. I'm not going to say the name. The sheriff's picture of daughter. Ooh. RuPaul's Drag Race, one queen goes home after emotional... No, because this is going to get serious. It's a Pulse tribute, you know, the Pulse nightclub. This is not a serious show. We don't do serious.
No.
Shark Tank contestant struggles to pitch new chopstick. Well, it's a video. I don't want to deal with that.
It's a chopstick. How many ways can you pitch a fucking chopstick?
You know, instead of three finger, you only use two finger. Am I being racist right now?
You pick up your...
Pretty much being racist.
Pretty much.
Pretty much. Harry Styles reveals the funny gift Adele gave him. Let's check this out. Ooh. Harry Styles reveals the funny gift Adele gave him for his 21st birthday. Dude, we got to check
Adele?
Adele, you know.
Oh, Adele.
Adele.
I was thinking the computers, and I was like, this isn't pop culture.
Yeah, you know how the apocalypse, how you know that it's apocalypse time? You know, like if you read the book of Revelation, there's like all these signs and like other belief systems, they have their own signs and everything else. But
yeah, and Nostradamus.
But really, the only way that you really know that it's apocalypse time, if Adele comes out and she sings this song, I'm happy, my boyfriend loves me, and he's never leaving me. Then you know.
He's doomed.
The whole planet is doomed because Adele only sings about, he stiffed me, he hates me, he's left me for another woman.
Who in their right mind would actually date her?
I would never. I'm like, girl, I heard your songs. You got a terrible track record. I ain't even. It's either something you're doing
get
or
over it.
You're
get over
it's
it.
It's either you or it's who you pick. Either way, it's you. So I'm staying away from Adele. Well, I'm happily married, but if I wasn't, Bodie, by the way, is looking. We're trying to find a nice male or female, whatever,
no,
you know.
Female.
Oh, female. Oh, I see. Oh, you're too good to consider male. I see. So you're one of those cis bigots, are you? That's what you are.
I mean, I like to leave it ambiguous for marketing purposes, but honestly,
honestly, you're swinging for the female side. So let's see what Harry Styles.
No,
got
not swinging
though.
For the female side.
You're not.
I'm not playing.
That didn't sound right. I didn't mean it like that. He's now batting for the females. Vody.
Wow.
Friend zone. Oh, he's batting for us. That puts him in the friend zone.
And up at bat is Frank Zundo.
I did help you one time with the friend zone.
Yeah, you helped me with that. That's great.
I
did not regret playing that first message, which she was like, oh, what are you talking about?
Why did you
do
let's
it? Find out.
Why? It was a telegram message.
It didn't dawn on me what Frank Zundo was. I was like, you're just being funny. This is going to be great.
Did she get it right away?
No, it took like 20 messages, and then I
what 20 messages? That's awesome.
She wanted to know. We got to
who's
the bottom.
Who's this Frank Zundo? Oh, friend zone. Oh yeah, he's right.
She was in short shorts and everything. Oh man, I was so close.
Okay, so this is what Adele. Okay, what to get the person who has everything for Adele? The answer was right at her fingertips. Oh, you know what? Actually, this explains a lot about. What the vengeance, yes. This explains a lot about the nature of her songs. When fellow Brit Harry Styles turned 21 in 2015, she gave him the gift of music. Her music, actually. For my 21st, she gave me one of her albums. 21. That's the name of the album, 21. The former he's a One Direction singer. I didn't even know that. We're doing a show about pop culture, and I didn't know that Harry Styles was from One Direction. Probably.
His name is Harry Styles, and she used her fingers. It's kind of weird.
21. So there's no surprise there that Adele is singing songs about dudes leaving her for other dudes. Because that's pretty crappy, isn't it? That's like, what if I were to get you, like, for your birthday... like a picture of me in a furry outfit. How would you feel about that?
I mean, I probably wouldn't know it was you right away.
It been like a guilt frame, but like a fake guilt, not like real guilt, like fake, not guilt, actual goal. What do you think?
Be all right.
You'd be all right? You wouldn't think that was creepy? It wouldn't be like 21 album kind of level creepy? Because I'm thinking...
No, I'd publish it. I would use that.
You'd use it against me in a bitter fit of rage.
It'd be great marketing.
Right. So we got Katherine Heigl has a cuddle party with her. I don't care about a cuddle party with her adorable kids. How is that news? I don't get it.
That's weird.
Oh, no, wait. Hold on. Her adorable kids are adopted and they're from minority status places. So that's probably why. That's why that's news. Look at me. I'm a mom and I rescued people from poor countries. Yay. Not that that's a bad thing.
So basically,
it's not a bad thing.
She kidnapped some poor kids, and they had no power to resist. And they're like, might as well be better than starving.
After this show, I'm never going to be able to run for president. I've said too much.
It's not like you're running for Congress or anything.
No, I can't. I mean, who would run for Congress in this day and age?
Only a sucker.
Only a sucker. A con artist at this point would run for Congress. That's the only one that I know. Let's try and find this celebrity news. I gotta say, I was at Us Weekly Celebrity News, and they're lame. Now I'm going
Us
to
Us Weekly
eat.
Or US Weekly.
I always say Us Weekly.
Pretty sure it's US.
You know what? I saw a meme once that explained how it was pronounced, and it's Us Weekly. Meme. What?
Hey, you had some dank maymays today.
I did have some dank maymays. We don't want to go into that though. I've already said enough not to be elected president. I don't want to get my wife to divorce me. So we don't want to talk about those maymays. Let's talk about Sugar Bear's wedding kiss. Let's not. I don't want to talk about who the heck is Sugar Bear? I've heard that name before. It's like if anybody, are you watching the comments? Because when I'm doing the stories,
no,
I can't.
My phone's actually dying.
Oh man, what you
want me to go get my charger?
What, you can't watch on your computer? You can't watch the comments on your computer? There are people that are dying because we're not responding to them. And we're missing out. Now I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to see if I see. Okay. Owen Nick says,
entertain them for 5 minutes, I can grab my charger.
Okay, go ahead, grab your charger. And Nick says, what's with the filter? Filter. Hey, Chris Boomer, sing it, Paul. My ears are bleeding. Are you serious? Okay, Chris, thank you for that. I think Sugar Bear is a singer, possibly rap, possibly hip hop. I have no idea, Chris. Why do you even know that? Why does anybody know who Sugar Bear is? I'm doing a show about pop culture, and I'm kind of agitated that people know who Sugar Bear is. How about this headline, folks? How Alex Rodriguez continues to win over... Oh, my gosh, no. No. Continues to win over Jennifer Lopez's heart. No! I am not doing a heartfelt story about celebrities. And about Alex Rodriguez, Mr. Steroids, for all you New York Yankees fans, total Mr. Roid man. I am not doing a story about how he's winning over Jennifer. He's probably pumping her full of steroids so that their steroid hearts are now in sync. Tyra Banks' hair is so in for festivals. I don't even get this headline. Tyra Banks' hair is so in for festivals. What does that mean, ladies and gentlemen? I doubt that our studio audience is even. Oh, look. Oh, Nick, I like this. You're like a haunted marshmallow. It's disturbing. I am not a haunt. I am a haunting marshmallow, not a haunted marshmallow.
He's a hulking marshmallow.
If you saw him
in real life, you'd be like, oh, what a hunk. Look at those nostrils. It's amazing. Actually, it's really creepy.
Dude, maybe we should call this episode White Privilege just because of the filter.
Yeah, I think so. I'm wearing my Hidden Commie shirt, my Truck Bump hat.
And I'm wearing a stupid shirt of some sort that I threw on because I thought it looked visually stupid. And I want to look stupid for this show. That way, If anybody ever listens to the show and tries to hold it to me against me, I'll say, did you see the way I was dressed? Do you really think that I was in my right frame of mind while I was doing this show? This show could not be held against me. But
I would love for someone to hold something against me. I am so lonely.
I bet you are. I bet I know. I can't relate to you. I have other experiences which are opposite of your experiences. So
my experiences.
Yes, opposite. I want to get your feedback on this. You weren't here when I read this headline. I want to get your feedback. Maybe if you think that I've passed over this story too quickly. How Alex Rodriguez continues to win over Jennifer Lopez's heart, even if it don't cost. Oh my gosh, I didn't read that part. Even if it don't cost a thing. What do you think? Should I click on that? I'm thinking. I mean, I was heading towards moving past it.
I'm good with moving past it.
I'm good with moving past it too. Everything we know about Olivia Munn and Aaron Rodriguez is split. What? Ooh, that looks gossipy. I like gossip. I'm clicking on that. Ladies and gentlemen, let's find out what's going on with Olivia Munn. I know who Aaron Rodgers is.
Oh, she's hot.
And Olivia Munn, I'm not so familiar with her.
Oh.
But I know who Aaron Rodgers is. Appendages?
Her front appendages, yeah.
What if she has... Okay.
I'd motorboat, yeah. Let's just say
we'd
have her in the boat if I was trying to rescue people during an Australian flood.
Let's just say that, our venture to find a woman for Bodhi is
dwindling.
It's facing an uphill climb at this point. It's going to be more daunting unless, of course, we can bury this show. We're going to bury this show shortly after the show's over. Although I'm recording it, so I am going to post it all over the place. And it's going to actually, my show, folks, is going to be in live Technicolor, unlike the marshmallow color that Bodhi chose. So this is the story, folks. Brace yourselves. Everyone is dying to know why they broke up. The couple, this is from eonline.com. I want to credit the source.
Oh, that's the best news.
It's the best. The couple who were together for 3 years. Oh my gosh, 3 years. That's epic.
Wow, that's serious.
Wow.
It's a serious relationship.
That is incredible. I mean, they're probably metaphorically, they're like great grandparents by now in that relationship. On Friday, a source close to Rogers confirmed the split. Okay, we know this. So who was the one to call it quits? The source shared. You know, by the way, the source is Putin, but I don't want to go down that road. It was Olivia that called the break. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It was Olivia that called the break. And though they've split, the insider adds that Munn and Rogers still communicate. Friends with benefits. Never mind. But the split has been hard on them. So if it's hard on you guys, why'd you split?
Why'd you do it?
Since they still communicate, does that mean there's a chance the couple might bet back together? Okay, so the headline was that everything...
No, she's coming for Bodhi.
Everything you... Yeah, she's coming probably to serve you your restraining order. Everything we know about Olivia Munn and Aaron Rodgers are split. Everything you need to know. All you know... I mean, that's the headline, folks. This is clickbait. I thought that a celebrity gossip site had some journalistic standards, but apparently they don't, because all we got from them is it was Olivia and they're still talking. That's everything you need to know. And besides that, who are they? Oh no. You know what? I read it wrong. I apologize, E Online. It says everything we know. That's different than everything you need to know. My bad. Oopsies. Wow. I hope they don't sue me, but I did.
Triggered.
I hope that I didn't inadvertently cause their...
I like how the show's going on. Your cheeks are getting rosier and the color
How is that possible?
I don't know.
So
it's amazing though.
We can look at tech news, celebrity news, weird news, odd news. What does our studio audience think we should do? Andrew looks like an handcuff in training. Oh yeah, yeah. No, no, no. That's not a look. That's a real thing, there, buddy.
That's not a myth.
That is definitely not a myth. I'm just going to say that's not a myth. So I'm going to go and pick. I'm going to pick odd news. What do you think?
Yeah, I like odd.
I'm going to pick odd news from UPI.com. Are you guys ready? These are the headlines, folks. I don't write them.
Yeah, Chris said weird or odd. Weird or odd.
Weird or odd. We're here, man. Well, there is weird and there's odd. So I went to odd. Twitter user seeks 18 million retweets for free Wendy's nuggets. Whoa.
But did they have Szechuan sauce?
Dude, that is... I can't even... Wow. You
can't even say Szechuan.
I can't. Wait, hold on. Schwan.
Szechuan.
Szechuan sauce.
Yeah.
Szechuan sauce.
That McDonald's sauce that was like 5 years old and it went for like
you're
a lot of money.
Yeah. It's going to be 9 more seasons for Rick and Morty before Rick finally gets it back again. I don't know if you saw the latest episode. Did you see the new Rick and Morty?
I still don't watch Rick and Morty.
What the heck is your problem? Get the freak off this show.
I had a huge issue with Rick and Morty because it totally overshadowed Samurai Jack's comeback.
So what you're saying is you're a commie.
I'd rather watch Samurai Jack.
You're a freaking commie and you vote. That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
You're a voting commie.
I'm a voting commie.
That's clear. If you don't like Rick and Morty, you're a voting commie.
You can call me a vommie.
Well, in the first episode of Rick and Morty, hey, and this is pop culture, so I could talk about it. It's good. In the first episode of Rick and Morty, Rick reveals probably the secret of secrets. Rick's raison d'etre, if you will. He's a raison d'etre. And it really is about getting back to the Szechuan sauce in McDonald's that McDonald's had for a very short time. And he made a reference that at toward the end of the show. Well, it was the end of the show, as all the credits were coming on. Dude, this is important. Don't zone out on me. You pay attention. Keep your eyeballs on me. Keep your freaking eyeballs on me. This is important. Look at me.
Do you know where I'm looking?
There you I'm looking at you and I can see that you're well, I don't know where you're looking, actually. Oh, no. Put the glasses back on. Put the glasses back on. Your eyes were not made for TV. Come on. Oh, that's I am so triggered. But at the end of Rick and Morty of episode one of the, season three, which was supposed to come out in the fall and just came out on April Fool's Day.
I just poked my eye.
That is nice. Yes. Hey, your glasses. You got poked in the eye.
The show gonna be a pirate.
You got poked in the eye from your glasses appendage. So it's always, and ladies
appendage
and gentlemen,
in my eye.
It always comes back to appendages. But Rick is Marty. You know, I'm telling you, Marty. You know, I'm gonna get that Szechuan sauce. I'm gonna get that Szechuan. So it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen, Morty. You know, maybe next season. You know, nine seasons, Morty. I'm gonna get this Szechuan sauce. That was my best Rick, man. That's all I could do.
Wow, I have nothing to compare it to, so I'm gonna say that was pretty good.
That's pretty awesome. Let's see what the studio audience said. Come on, you guys. What do you guys have to say? Yeah, and Chris said you'll put. Oh, he said you'll put your eye out. I think he meant you'll poke your eye out. Yeah. But. Well, Chris said, holy crap, in this filter, when you took off those glasses, we've now found your nightmare fuel. And you can also see into, can we revile Trump Revolution post, Larry? I don't know what that is, but no. Oh, I mentioned the T word. The T word is off balance on this show. I have to, you know what, at the end of the show, I'm going to have to flagellate myself. Probably a good five flagellations will suffice. Yeah, I'm gonna whip myself for all you folks that don't have a vocabulary beyond the second grade.
Wait, so, that's not what it's called.
Yeah, flagellation.
No, you're referring to flatulence.
No, flatulence is farting.
Flagellation.
Flagellation is F-L-A-G-G. Let me see. Hold on, folks. We're taking.
Isn't that Craigslist? Just random right now. There's a Craigslist ad for a guy. He was looking for a woman to fart in his mouth with gas.
It seems inappropriate.
But that was the ad. He just, but like, fart. He wanted someone to. He wanted.
It's 1G
in his mouth with gas.
I'm already bored with this story. You bored me. I'm sorry. I can't.
With
gas. You can't even sustain. When you can't even sustain.
How many other types of farts are there?
When you can't even sustain a story about a dude trying to pay a lady to fart in his mouth, you're not a good host. That's. I mean, just admit it. Just own it. And we're gonna move on. And by the way, flagellation. FLAG. ELLATION. Oh. Not the flatulence. Not FLAT. FLAG. Well, it wasn't exclusively Christian, but there was a lot of monks who. I'm not doing that. I'm not going down that road. Anyway, for the fact that I mentioned the T word twice during the show, that is going to cause me to self-flagellate at the end of the show. And no, Pixar, it didn't happen. You're just going to have to take my word. I'm not documenting that. So Wendy's challenged a Twitter user to accumulate 18 million retweets on a single tweet to earn a year of free chicken McNuggets. But that's a horrible thing to do. Are you kidding me?
Why would you eat that many chicken nuggets?
Why would Wendy's do that to someone? Wendy's is doing... Well, first off, why would you need a year of free chicken? Right. I mean, chicken nuggets, I like my processed garbage food as much as anybody else. But a year's worth of chicken nuggets, that's a little bit too much
garbage.
But
what is a year's worth? Do they mean like 5 a week?
Well, again,
for a year?
These are where words have a problem.
Are they talking about the 10-piece meal?
Words.
They discontinued the spicy chicken nuggets. So as far as I'm concerned, chicken nuggets at Wendy's are out.
Are dead to me. They're dead to me. But regardless, let's just assume that these actually taste good. And really, if you're going to go to Wendy's, you're going to only eat the Baconator. That is God's food right there. You're going to hit the Frosty. Frosty is the nectar of the gods. And that's it. Anything else, you don't need
it. Chili cheese fries.
You're a lying man whore. Just shut your whore mouth. Because you're a lion and you're wrong. So,
roar.
So let's just pretend, though, that chicken nuggets actually taste good at Wendy's. And they don't. But let's just pretend they do.
Some of the best chicken nuggets.
Oh, my gosh. You're such a freaking liar. How much are you being paid by Wendy's? Is Wendy's owned by the Russians, by the way?
You see how much I'm
beginning to see a pattern.
Wendy's is all about the commies.
Right. Right. You're right. Wendy's with the red hair. Boom. Boom. How did I not see this in advance? So,
probably because of the color correction.
So Carter Wilkerson tweeted at the fast food chain's official Twitter account to ask how many retweets would earn him a year's supply of his favorite treat. And what he literally said was, "Yo, Wendy's, how many retweets for a year of free chicken nuggets?" And then Wendy's set the bar at 18 million. Wendy should have just responded back to him, you know, your soul and all of your time, your life, and everything that you're doing on pause for the next 5 years.
Did he get 18 million retweets?
I'm getting to it. Let's find out. Dude, this is a story worth examining. These are the kinds of stories that we cover on Lozilla.
I'm examining
These are the breaking news stories that are covered on Lozilla. We cover crap so that you don't have to. That's what we do. Hey, you know, that could be our slogan. We cover crap.
We're clearly not doing anything. We're clearly not doing anything with our Friday night. So
you got a great point there. Help me, please. Wilkerson wrote, "A man needs his." Oh my gosh, he said, "A man needs his nugs." I don't know any man that has ever woken up, and if he did say that he meant what that guy meant.
No,
Or appendage, or could be some sort of shrubbery involved in the nug concept, but not chicken nuggets. His tweet soon went viral, receiving more than 1 million retweets, and Wendy's was like, oh no, he's going to do it, he's going to bankrupt, he's going to chicken bankrupt. Can you chicken bankrupt somebody?
He's going to chicken bank him.
Chicken bank him. He's going to chicken bank us! 1 million officially shook. Oh, see, that's what 1 million officially shook, the Wendy's Twitter page wrote after Wilkerson achieved a milestone. You know, I don't have it in front of me. I don't have it memorized, but Wendy's.
That much advertising, though? That's totally worth a year of chicken nuggets.
Oh, Wendy's is making out in this deal. Wilkerson's soul is being crushed and his whole life is being monopolized.
I mean, he's probably going to die from chicken intake.
Oh, and that's where we're at, folks. That's where we're at. And this story is dated April 7th. So it's today. Today is today. Day 7th.
That is today.
So he's only up to 1 million, folks. So if you want to help poison a man and hasten his death, please retweet and help him. Otherwise, he's going to spend the rest of his miserable, pathetic life trying to get to 18 million retweets just so that he could spend the next year after that eating himself to death. Wendy's, good move. Good move. Good move. I'm very proud of Wendy's at this point. You know, okay, UPI, you did us good. So we're going to stay on UPI. And we're going to see. We got Florida man sues to keep inflatable Super Mario outside business. I don't care about that. Do you care about that? I don't. Driver Ford, no. I don't care about Driver Ford, know about. Oh my gosh, wait. No, they snuck in sponsored content. I just read a sponsored content headline. I feel like I should be paid in Wendy's nuggets.
You literally just read an ad.
I just literally read an ad. I should get a year supply of Wendy's nuggets. Even though Wendy's has nothing to do with Ford, I should still.
Chris has already retweeted them. So that's
nice. Hey, that's 1,000,001, Chris. Good job. Good job.
On our way to killing a man. Good job.
Yes, I mean help us kill this man. Well, not literally. Let's not. Camel steals food bag while ostrich. I don't care about that. Canadian police search for stolen. I don't care. Holy crap. Wait, hold on. A stolen cell phone tower. What do you think?
Yeah, I actually read that article.
Oh, we got to go check this out.
This happened in Canada.
That's what it says.
Manitoba, right?
Well, I hope it happened in Canada because it did say Canadian police. So it had happened in Pennsylvania and Canadian police are searching.
RMCP, Royal Mounted Canadian Police.
If that's the case, then we have been invaded by Canada.
Dudley Do-Right is on the case.
I actually think that Canada was thinking about invading us. And never mind, I almost said the T word again. It has something to do with Tomahawk missiles, but I won't. I won't play that one out.
Hey, have you seen Aleppo?
I have not.
I don't think they have either.
Okay. Never mind. Police in Canada are seeking information regarding a stolen tower. Come on.
20 meters in height.
20 meters in height. How much is it that in real feet? In real length?
Really fucking tall.
Because 20 meters is not a real measurement. That's like measurement.
It's not something easy. And it was, believe it was disassembled and packed onto a Dodge truck of all trucks. I can't believe it got away.
Yeah, the tower was disassembled and loaded onto a trailer behind a red Dodge dually truck. What is a dually truck? Well, you're proud because you memorized that useless fact? You want a jelly bean because fact?
I had an argument with a coworker over how surprised I was that a Dodge got away.
Oh, because it started and it ran?
Yeah.
Oh, right. But I actually used to have a Dodge Durango, and actually, I loved that
thing. This coworker used to have a Dodge as well, and it suffered the same fate.
I had a Dodge Durango, and it was good. I loved it. And
it's probably killing him that I'm not going to even mention his name.
I had the Dodge Durango, and the only reason I don't have it anymore is because it was during a period of time when the gas was going really, really high, and we thought it would stay high. And in retrospect, I'm like, man, I should have held on to it because I loved that thing. It was 529 horsepower, four-wheel drive.
How'd they get that many horses under the hood?
They lured him in with chicken nuggets.
There we go.
chicken nugget. Yeah, come on into the engine, boys. Like, retweets. 500. Yep. Well, thanks. And I don't know.
The next thing you know, your cell tower's missing.
Right. Next thing you know, your cell tower's missing. According to police, the truck was last seen Monday traveling east on Provincial Trunk Highway. That's an exciting name, isn't it?
What the hell are they going to do with it?
I'm more intrigued with the name Provincial Trunk Highway. That is just...
And as soon as they assemble it and use it, they can find it.
They're probably just going to use the components for different things, doofus.
What else do you use a cell tower for?
For... I don't know. Do I look like a cell tower technician? Don't answer that.
What the hell? What are they going to use it for? I want to know what they're going to use it for. I say that they just stop the investigation, let them build it.
Yeah. If you build it, they will come and arrest you. I like that. Okay, so I don't know if we want to do another odd story. What do you think? We've got about 15 minutes because our show's only an hour long, folks. That's it.
Yeah.
That's all we give you. We got 15 minutes left. So should we go? We could go Aleppo. I heard that's delicious dog food. Chris, actually, that is actually correct. Aleppo is delicious dog food. Ask me how I know.
For the state.
What? Aleppo. Did you ever try Aleppo? It's great dog food.
No, I like dog food, though. Dog food's delicious.
It's awesome. Aleppo is like the runny, chunky kind, too.
And I like
The runny, chunky kind is the best kind. That actually, Chris is the one who
just like Mother used to make.
Right, just like Mother used to make. So we have Man Films confrontation with tent invading skunk. I don't care about that. New Zealand Prime Minister shocks. Oh, no, the spaghetti Hong toppings. Hong Kong
Fui Prime Minister.
Oh, that's true. I stand correct because that is New Zealand, which is
Zealandia.
By the way, we'll have to.
We still have a show coming up on that.
We're working on, folks. We are doing the kind of investigative reports that won us
flat earthers need.
Could theoretically win us a Pulitzer Prize. That's the kind of investigative reports that
we've already won like three. We've won two Nobel Peace Prizes because of our first two studies.
Right. Yeah.
And so it's about time we get a Pulitzer.
Yeah, it's about time. No, I don't want a Pulitzer Pizza Prize because it's probably going to involve pineapples.
With the peas and stuff. Unless it's pepperoni. Pepperoni's okay.
Speeding deer tramples Canada man outside hotel. Oh, that's a visual. I can't handle visuals. Turkey dashes. Oh, me no. Okay, Chinese goo. Zoo, goo. Chinese goo. I like Chinese goo better. I'm going to read it. It's really zoo, but I'm going to stick with goo. Chinese goo lets guests clean up polar bear poop for $145. I think that's worth a check. What do you think?
Sounds about right.
Let's dive right in. Let's find out. So this is Chinese zoo is making some extra cash and promoting education by charging guests $145 for the privilege of cleaning up polar bear poop. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're worried about China after this story, you don't need to worry about China. Because if you're paying to pick up poo, probably the DNA is not being assembled in the right order.
Now, what kind of a scam is that? Like,
it's pretty sweet. I wish I could work that deal.
They should be paying people to pick up the poo.
I don't begrudge them if they figured out if they found if they that figured out niche, how to charge for it.
Now, what I want to know is, do they get the bears out of the containment?
Why would you do that
area?
Why would you do that?
Or do we literally have Chinese people paying money to go into a polar? You said a polar bear den.
Yeah, polar bear den.
To pick up poo.
Well, they're cute and fluffy and white and I don't know what white has to do with it. But
I would love to see that.
That's the theme of the show is white privilege. So that's.
I can't wait. Oh my god, the live streams from that are going to be amazing.
Oh, and they could charge. They could actually charge for the live streams. You could pay a subscription to watch people. Will they be killed? Will they not be killed? Will the polar bear charge? Come on, dude. So,
oh, that'd be good. That is primetime TV. Right
hold on. I'm about ready to impress you here. Ready? The Wuhan Heicheng Ocean Park in Hubei Province. Nailed it! Totally nailed it. Is offering. Wow. Did you see the way I totally nailed that? For the Chinese people listening right now are like, is this Chinese? I know.
I thought you were Chinese for a second.
And when I read it, I actually thought I was Chinese for a second.
I was like, where did Paul go?
I know. Exactly. Chinese will get this. While I read it and I was drinking cold water, all of a sudden I felt very uncomfortable. I felt very unhealthy. That's a Chinese joke. Because the Chinese don't drink cold water. They believe that cold water is bad for you and you should drink warm water. Well, you're a commie, so I don't really care.
Well, no, you know why that is, right? Because the body in order for your body to actually use water, it has to heat it up.
Nobody cares. Nobody cares about your interesting factoids.
Drinking cold water is not actually refreshing.
Does anybody who is listening to this care about his interesting factoids? Chris is the only one commenting. Chris, you are a soldier. Who knew what part was Chinaman And what part was supposed to be Paul? Actually, Chris, I think you've listened to some shows before, and I don't want to have to talk about my OP heritage again, but I will. I'm OP. You guys call it Neanderthal, but I'm OP, original people. And I'm not going to get into that right now because this is a fun show. Yeah. I don't want to get personal and bring people down with the persecution of my people. And
you have roots with the failed species.
It's not. We're rising. We're OP rising. That's what we are. We're OP rising. So
sure.
So watch your back, Homo sapiens sapien. Just saying.
Homo sapiens sapien. Yeah.
That's what you are. You're Homo sapiens sapien, which is stupid because that means you're double wise, but it's like the opposite is of what you are. So the guest, they must go, in case you're worrying about the polar bears, the guest must undergo health checks. So they make sure that you're not going to hurt the polar bear. And I think that's really, really nice. I'm about ready to do a quote here. Should I do like a racist Chinese accent quote, or should I give it a twist and give it like some weird accent that doesn't make any sense?
No, you can go for it right now, Paul.
It really costs money to smell poop, but it's quite funny. Li Fengang, 26, a zoo guest who recently took the polar bear experience, told China News Network, or not China News Service, it's hard to see polar bear, not to mention come into close contact with them and potentially die. Park spokesperson Chen Ting said the goal of the program is education. It's the first time the park has had a program targeting adults, Chen said. It is a pilot to popularize science and knowledge of the animal for the public good, not for money. See, it's not racist when you make fun of Southern accents. It's different. We actually don't want too many.
Anytime I see Chinese people, I'm going to imagine them speaking in a Southern accent now. Thank you, Paul.
You're welcome. So I've done that to you. And I think that I think we have time for maybe two more stories. What do you think?
Yeah, one, we got 10 minutes.
So should we do two? So where do we go next? We could go to entertainment. We could go to odd news. We could go to tech. What's the pulse of the rousing crowd of one have to say? What does our studio audience have to say about this?
I like the odd stuff, the weird stuff, personally.
But we've done the odd stuff and the weird stuff.
Okay, go to tech.
Hey, there's more stuff here and I missed it. Hey, Walt. I didn't see you here, Walt. Hey, Walt. Walt Bedford is here. And Tammy Hogue. Tammy, if I'm mispronouncing your last name, Bodie told me how to pronounce it. She said it's Hogue. He said Hogue. I said it looks like Hogue.
It's Hogue.
How do you pronounce it? H-O-U-G-H. How do you pronounce that?
I was going to say, I'm going to refrain.
No. I'm scared. No, now you're afraid, right? Because you don't want to be.
You just screwed it up, and now I don't know.
You don't want to not know or be called out and embarrassed and like, come on, dude. We've been doing this show for almost an hour. You don't have to. I mean, you're past embarrassment at this point. We're gonna stick with. We're gonna stick with weird.
I don't know why I'm thinking like who or how or how who how. I don't want to say ho.
I don't want to say ho. If it is ho, Tammy, it's fine. I don't judge you.
I don't judge you.
I don't judge you for your last name being Ho. If it's, I think it's How. I'm gonna guess How. I'm not gonna say Hogue. I said Hogue. Tammy, you have to phonetically spell it for us. If you're still there, she may have seen too much.
I think we lost her.
I think we've lost everyone. We were up to like 30, and now we're down to one. North Carolina girl 5 throws Costco. What the heck? I don't care about that. New York police seize illegal caiman. Dude, an illegal caiman. They seize an illegal caiman during drug raids. Listen, man, I thought we had to deal with the illegal aliens. Now we got an illegal caiman. You know,
what the hell is a caiman?
And here's the thing. You don't know what a caiman is? It's like a type of alligator thing. But listen, you know, you might not realize this, but caiman that are here legally, that went through the right channels, they actually disapprove of illegal caiman. It's a little known fact. But we're not going to touch that story because it's stupid. Cat takes... touch it. I glossed over it. Cat takes sip from Latvian mayor's mug during interview. Ooh! Whoa! Oh, he's a real person. Look, he let his cat drink it. No, he's a bloodthirsty killer. Well, I'm not saying he is. It would be funny if he was, though. Not really funny, but I'll shut up. Go ahead. I shut up. Go ahead. You're going to do the rest of the show. You have no stories. You have nothing. And you have 6 minutes left to entertain the studio audience. And go.
I'd like to just say that this was a really fun show.
Probably the
best. This is relaxing. This is probably the best production we've ever done. And that's not saying much.
No, it's... No.
Not at all.
No, it's not. Oh, Chris said something about he has to hydrate the cat.
The pussy.
He used a different word. I wasn't going to do that.
If you're going to read the comments, read the comments.
I am not going to do that. Chris apparently has been watching this for an hour. Chris, how did you manage? How did you? What? You must be a lonely man.
We won't tell your friends.
We won't tell your friends. But do you want us to help you find someone? Is that why you're here? Because we're helping Bodie. You can't probably see it in the ghost, but I'm doing the quotes. We're helping Bodie. We're gonna make this happen here.
Yeah, I have a really weird track record, so.
Yeah.
We're not talking about that.
Yeah, well, we're not, we're absolutely not going to talk about that.
Do you think she still watches the shows?
There's a lot of she's in that she, so what she you she-ing?
Yeah, they actually help.
So, I don't know. There's a lot of she's that could be watching that would fit into that category. Well, we won't go there. So let's see. Do we got anything really cool in tech to close the show out with? Anything? Shuttleworth gives up hope for convergence breakthrough. I don't even know what that means. Zoomans hybrid electric planes could disrupt commercial flight industry. That's boring. Come on, give me something exciting. Google gives developers first look at Android Zero.
Is Daryl commenting on the outside of the video?
Daryl? Who's Daryl?
Just Daryl commented on the video. Daryl DeVille.
Daryl, why aren't you in the Nepal thing? Because then I can't see your comments. Daryl. Oh, no,
that's a different video.
Daryl, you definitely dropped out of high school, didn't you? Just admit it. Just admit that you dropped out of...
His name's Daryl.
Daryl is one of my... poking enemies. And by the way, we're going to have to do tomorrow. Actually next week.
We can't do it tomorrow?
Yeah, we could do it tomorrow. Yeah, totally.
Okay.
Yeah, actually that would be better. Yeah. We are going to, why don't we announce that?
Yeah, we'll do the Poke War report.
That's also on Napaw TV, right?
That is on Napaw TV.
And exclusive. That's not exclusive. That one's getting simulcast.
Oh, whatever.
I'm going to simulcast that on. Actually, no, that is an Atop Pat T. Never mind. That's an exclusive show. So the Poke Wars 2017. That's right. I forget. I mean, it's hard to keep track of all the stuff that you do that you drag me into. So,
oh, God.
Really. So Poke Wars 2017, we will be doing. And I'm sure that maybe Daryl will get a mention. He didn't get a mention in the last episode. And I have noticed that we have a lot more contenders, and we've gotten some complaints from people who were not mentioned. So you'll have to join us tomorrow. We don't know when, but
make sure you poke us.
Make sure you poke us.
Because
otherwise,
at midnight tonight, our pokebacks stop. And we're
actually
be
my
pokes.
Pokeback stopped right now. So start poking me now, so that what we need is. We have to have that screenshot so that we see all the folks that poke us, and then we can talk about it. So I think, when don't we wrap the show up? What do you think? We got like a minute left.
Yeah. This is pretty good. Well, thanks for watching. Remember to like the page, like the video. People that have commented, thank you so much.
Yes. It means everything to us.
Make sure you share this so all of your friends suffer and wonder what the hell is wrong with you.
Yeah. Yeah, and if we get views and comments and stuff, then we'll do more of these. Otherwise, we're like, who the hell cares?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, if we don't get much of a response,
they're like,
then
screw
it's...
it. Screw it, man. Screw it.
But I could do another one of these. I'd probably do more.
I like this. I like this format. I think this is great. This is just chill and,
We should get James Weeks involved.
Well, we'll have, like, they'll have different people on at times. Yes. Yeah,
different people. But he expressed interest.
So. No more than one guest at a time.
Yeah.
No more than three people. Because I've definitely we've done it with four and even more, and really three is good. Yep. I think four is too much. And on that note, I am going to end my part, which is actually a recording, which I plan on putting on. I don't know where I'm going to put the recording on, but my recording is actually going to be in live Technicolor. So you'll see the live Technicolor version of Lozilla on other channels, including YouTube and Facebook. And that's it.
Thanks for watching.
So we'll see you next whenever.
Keep carrying
right?
on. You've said it like 8 times.
So we'll see. So I was going to say, you'll see you next week. And I was like, no, I don't really know when we'll see you.
And I say, thanks for watching. And that's a great note to end on. Right? Try it.
Thanks for watching.